What is up, everybody? I'm Rav Holly, and today I'm going to be doing something a little bit different, something I haven't done before, but something that when I'm buying a piece of equipment, I search YouTube for these videos, and it's unboxing videos and the little initial review when somebody gets something new. So today, I'm doing my first unboxing video. I hope you enjoy it. We got some wind outside. Charlie's running around the studio, so there might be some noise, but we're going to get to doing unboxing. But first, let me give you a little initial about what we're doing here. This is my camera bag, my camera backpack that I've used now for about 5 years. I got this in, going on 6 years. I got this in 2009. And I used to actually somewhat be sponsored by Kiesel. K-I-E-S-E-L. And they were a bag company based out of San Diego, California. And basically, I was shooting a UFC event, and they contacted me and asked me if I wanted one of their bags and that they would give me a good discount on it. So basically, I paid their company wholesale price, their employee wholesale price or whatever, which was about $35 for this bag. And it is an amazing bag. And I actually wanted a new one. I've had this one for so long. It's been all over the world. It's got pockets in it. I still have my NBC Universal tag on here from Europe, when I was in Europe, in case it got lost when I was working for NBC Universal in Europe, that they could call this number for NBC Universal and return my bag, which with the amount of gear I had in this bag, if it got lost, I probably would have never got it back, but that's why I didn't let it out of my sight. It's starting to get a little bit worn. It, and the inside dividers are starting to get a little bit worn. But this bag literally carries pretty much everything. It's got all your pockets up here, like the backpack, my flash. It's just got room for everything, except two camera bodies with lenses. And so I've always been a little bit, I carry two camera bodies in it, but it's a little bit tight, and the dividers are getting a little bit worn, and I just decided, and the other thing is, I have so many bodies and I can't carry all the chargers and stuff for the cameras and the batteries. And to make a long story short, I've just been antsing to get a new Pelican. So I actually have gotten a new Pelican case, and that's what the unboxing is going to be. And a quick note, when I went to replace this bag or looked to see if they had a bigger bag, they've actually went out of business. So you can't even get this bag anymore, which is such a big downer for me because I have a camera strap. It's called I can't think of what it's called. I have it here somewhere. It's amazing. I love it. It's called, and there's a couple other companies that make these same type of straps. It's called a Carry Speed. And it's the only one I know, though, that has the thing up here so I can carry my CF cards in it. So, out of business. They got put out of business, too. Anyway, without further ado, let's get on to something new. And here it is. The Big Bad Pelican 1510. And I can't remember, I actually ordered this Pelican with an inside insert. There's a lot of YouTube videos on YouTube with this particular case, the 1510, which is it's the TSA approved carry-on. So I can actually carry this on just like my backpack, which is why I ordered it. And I actually own a big 1650 Pelican that transports a lot of equipment across country and stuff. But I actually decided to see about going with a Pelican for my everyday camera bag, which I can put up to hopefully four camera bodies in this thing if I want to. So without further ado, let's see what it looks like. And the other thing about this Pelican case, I ordered this with an insert in it, and I can't remember. I think it's called a 1523. I'll have to look that number up. Look in the description. I'll put the link to the Pelican 1510, which I think it's called a 1520 or something like that with an insert. I can't remember, but it's a 1510, and with a 1523 or something insert in it. And out of all the reviews that I saw on YouTube, I didn't see one with this insert. So, and this is the insert that I wanted. And there she is. There's a lot of different inserts for this. You can order it with just the foam insert. So you basically cut out and place your stuff in there. So it's just a pullout. Or as a camera person, a camera photographer or whatever, you can order photography inserts. And that's what I got. And I got the one that has the insert for the top, the two. And usually the one for the top is just a mesh insert. And you put your, you know, your flash cards, your SIF cards, and all your stuff in there. But I ordered one that I could put my laptop in. And I haven't seen it, so let's see what it looks like. If it'll even open. Yeah, buddy. There we go. So there's my laptop insert right there. There's all of my Pelican information. Warranty card. Yeah, this thing is exactly what I was looking for. I love it. And let's see, we have probably put my CF cards here. I got enough for lenses, two camera bodies, flash. Yeah, this thing is really, really nice. And it's really, really what I was hoping it was going to be. Let's actually look and see if the MacBook Pro 15 inch will actually fit in the insert. I have ordered a smaller MacBook Pro. I ordered a 13 inch because I'm trying to be more mobile. But look at that. It's actually perfect. Wow. It could not have fit any better. I was worried I got another MacBook because I didn't think it would fit. But it's actually made for a 15 inch. That's crazy. I mean, it fits in there absolutely perfect. It couldn't have fit any better. And of course, I ordered this to be, well, getting it out may be a little bit different. I ordered this to be my everyday camera bag now. I plan on pretty much switching all of my gear to this and taking it everywhere. The backpack I love. It's very convenient to carry around. Probably even more convenient than this. I know you can, I think, get backpack straps for this for about $100, $99. Or if you wanted to use this as a backpack, you could. And I think it'll go right there on the back. And it does, you know, it's a pull around. Let me figure out how it works. There we go. So you can drag it around with you. And it's watertight, waterproof down to 30 feet, I believe. So yeah, 30 feet. It also will float in salt water. So if you have to ditch, or if you're in a boat out in the ocean, it falls off the deck. If it's closed, it should float. So I'm going to bring you guys over a little bit closer. We'll take a look at the inside. All right, guys. Now we can take a look at the inside. I think you can see the inserts there. I really like this this new insert. I like the black. I know the other photography insert is like a gray, and it's that felt material, which I don't like at all because it gets really dirty and it really it ages over time. So I like this material, this shiny material that's more of a polyurethane or something. I like it a lot better than the old felt type of inserts that you used to get with the camera stuff. Let's see. I have a camera here and a lens. Let's throw this in here and see what it looks like. You can put a lens here. I think, though, I want to fix this where my camera bodies go here in the front. Oh, it's a little tight. Actually, may have to go right here. Yeah, they are. I may switch that around because I plan to have my camera bodies here and my lenses here. So I actually may have to switch that around. I'm not really sure how that's going to work. Yeah, it doesn't work that way at all. Could do it that way, but that's not what I have planned. So the straps, on the other hand, are going to be a little bit different. Let's bring over, let's see. I have another camera body here. Here's the old trusty D700. And And let's see what it looks like in there. Now, one thing that I did do is in my bag is I carried my camera with lens on it. Oh, yeah, it fits just like that. So I wasn't always having to remove my lens and attach it to my camera. So I will probably leave this like this and change it up just a little bit, because I do a lot of times carry my lens on the camera, so I get less dust in my sensor by changing camera lenses all the time and pulling the lens off. Let me find a cover. For said camera and lens. All right. There we go. And there's our lenses. And there's our cameras. There we go. So now we have, wow, the D700 with a grip doesn't fit. That's not good. You have to take the grip off. Yeah, that's not good at all. Wow. That's a real disappointment. This is a big camera, though. If you know, the D700 with a grip on it is a big camera. So, but that is going to be something that I do have to work on and figure out. It's not going to work like that, because it just sticks up too high. I don't even think it'll close. Yeah, it won't close. Oh. I don't want to have to take my grip off my D700 every time that I travel with it. So that's going to be something I have to check out. I'll have to figure that out. The D7000, the backup, it fits in just fine. So it's just the D700 because it is a big camera body. Yeah, actually the D7000 fits perfect. But the D700 with the grip, not so much. But there's how I planned on having it. Put our lenses in there. The big Nikon lens. I guess I'll have to go there. Gosh, this thing is tight. There we go. So anyway, guys, I've got to figure this out. That's going to be a problem, because I don't want to be de-gripping my 700 just to carry it around. Oh, there we go. I think it'll work, maybe. I just probably won't be able to put anything in this pocket if I carry the 700 there, though. But I did get it to work. I'm not quite comfortable with it sticking up that much, but I guess it won't hurt it. I guess it'll be a tight fit, actually. All right, guys. Well, there is the unboxing of the Pelican 1510. I hope it gives you an idea. I haven't used it much. I'll probably do another review after I use it for a while, and I'll let you guys know what I think of it. But I do like the fact that I can put my laptop in here, my MacBook, my batteries, all of my good stuff. My SIF cards will probably go in here. My flash. Again, we can slide. If you looked earlier, I slid this in. My MacBook Pro. Slide it right in here. And it fits perfectly. And like I said, I'm going to go ahead and take the Pelican stuff out. Like I said, I actually ordered a 13-inch MacBook because I thought it would be lighter to carry and it would fit better, but this sleeve is actually made for a 15-inch. But I think a 13 will be easier to get in and out of there. But there it is. And then you got a whole pocket here. Let's see. Let me find my flash. I don't know that this Pelican is going to hold as much gear, though. I don't think it's going to hold as much gear as a backpack. I think the backpack will hold a whole lot more gear to a certain extent. There's a flash. Oh, flash doesn't go down either. Wow. So that's something to consider. You can't just like... I guess maybe if I take the flash out, because I actually looked at a picture of one of these and saw a flash. Yeah, so you could carry the flash like that, but I actually always carry my flash in its protective case, because I keep the batteries and everything in the case as well for the flash. So, and this is not even the big flash, like the big 900. This is my old SB600. So it's one of the smaller, lighter weight flashes Nikon makes. That's why I got it. And so I'm going to have to move some stuff around and get this, because that's sticking up way too high for it to, I think even for it to close, yeah. So probably have to, you know, get these dividers set where I can set this down in there sideways instead of up this way. But there it is, guys, just to let you know, it is small and it is compact. And even a D700 with a battery grip on it sticks up about that much too high. So I'm gonna have to rework this thing and get it just right. And when I do, and I use it for a couple of weeks, I'll come back and give you another review. But for the time being, when I get my, I'll put my 70 to 200 F2.8 probably in there, but until, I'll probably use it for my flash like that. And put the camera straps over like that. And I've got so much gear though, batteries for the D700 are right here. And that's why I ordered this, was to be able to carry all of my batteries for all of my cameras. And even if I wanted to put all four of my camera bodies in here, I could actually put them in here. I'm recording on my Nikon D5100 right now. I have my old, that I bought new back in 2010, my old D90, which I don't really use any much anymore. Thing's got almost 100,000 clicks on it. But, I mean, I could actually throw it in here too. And there's three camera bodies right there. So that's something that you can't do, I can't do with that backpack. There's no way I can fit three camera bodies. And what I could actually do here, because I'm not going to carry the 90, but I am going to carry the 5100 that I'm recording this on, and it does have a grip on it. So I'm sure you know how these work. You just kind of take them out and rework them how you want them. So the D5100, which I record video on mostly right there, will go right there. And then I will put this right here. There we go. There we go. That looks pretty cool. And then the flash, I'm still gonna have to work this flash out. I don't like that at all. It's gotta go somewhere. So anyway, I guess I could take it out of the pouch. Let's see what happens. Yep. You can take it out of the pouch, but you definitely gotta fold it if you're gonna do that. There we go. That's perfect. So I guess we'll probably be doing away with the pouch, because or its own protective case that it came with, because it doesn't look like I'm going to need it. I always carry it because I can carry stuff in there, but it fits in there perfect without it. So there we go. And then you can lay these over, camera straps you can lay over, and then my carry speed, which is my detachable that goes around my it's a holster type strap. It can go right here as well. And now I've got my MacBook in there, two camera bodies, my CF cards are gonna probably have to go right here. I have a whole nother pack for those. I have binoculars that I carry with me. They'll go there. My CF cards will probably go in here, if they will. Yeah, perfect. CF cards go in there. Battery chargers to all of these cameras. Hopefully they can go in here somewhere. Yeah. Yeah, there's two battery chargers there. And the cords for them can go right there. So we pretty much transferred some stuff over. This backpack has still got a ton of stuff in it. I've still got some other lenses in this backpack. So all of this stuff for these top dividers probably aren't gonna fit. So we'll have to figure that one out and just bring it down a little bit, but we've got it now. Oh no, it won't close. That's not good. Let's see. I think it's going to be, let's see, I have cards being in here. So we'll be able to take those out. And is there one divider left anywhere? Don't see one. Let's see. Oh, right here. Put them right, put the CF cards right there. Charger cables go right there. There we go. Now it should close. Yes. And we are ready to travel the world. Perfect. Oh, it is heavy. I don't know if it'll make, I don't know if that'll make the 60 pound or whatever it is restrictions. That is heavy. So that's something to take into consideration as well. Because the Pelican case itself weighs a lot. That backpack right here is very, very light, but this Pelican case is not light in its own right. It's pretty heavy. So yeah, it's definitely heavy. But it is carry-on size, so you can carry this on an airplane with you, which is what I like about it. But as far as gear, with the MacBook Pro and two camera bodies, two lenses, probably not going to be able to get much more gear in here because I pretty much think it weighs pretty close to 45, 50 pounds, just like that. But for protecting your gear, you really cannot beat these Pelican cases. So anyway, guys, we're going to go ahead and end this off right here. I hope you've enjoyed my unboxing and moving gear over to the Pelican 1510. And I will get you guys if you look at the description, I will put this divider with your laptop case, which I have not seen a review with one of these on YouTube. So nobody's ordered this particular setup and did a review. So I'm the only one that I know of that I found. So I'll let you know after I use it a while. I'll do a full review on it and let you know what I think. This whole case, the case itself is called the 1510, but if you order it with the laptop for the top lid and the bottom divider, it's called a Pelican 1510 SC. And you can order them on Amazon right now for $274. And you're still gonna have shipping on top of that. So in all, you're gonna be looking, I think about $320, I think, for this setup. So it's not cheap. A little disappointed with how far up my D700 sticks with a body grip on it. So that's a little bit disappointing. But you know, the D700's a big camera, but if you're carrying a big full professional SLRs on a Canon, like the 1DX, those are big cameras. If the D4, the D3s, they're all about that same size. Actually, I do know the 700 is a little bit bigger with a grip on it than a D3. It is a bigger camera. I think it's the biggest Nikon with a grip on it. So maybe that explains it. It's the only one of that size, because the D7000, the backup behind it, fits in perfect. So it's just the 700 that sticks up like that. So I'm going to have to figure out if every time I travel with this, if I'm going to actually take the grip off the bottom. It's not hard, it just screws right off. But the problem is with lenses, anything, one tip I can give you guys is when you have camera equipment, the more you undo things and the more you mess around with stuff, the more you change lenses. I'm a stickler because I started in the film days, and literally we used to take our body cap off and throw our lens on really quick so we didn't get dust in the lenses or on the sensor of our cameras, and to keep them clean, especially with the very first DSLRs, because they would get dirty so fast. So the best thing I recommended when I started was to literally not take your lens off your camera. Get your workhorse, which has always been a 24-28 to 70-28 for me. This is the old, which I love this lens. It's the old version of the Nikon, the 28. It's a beast, 4 pounds. But it, you know, it's always been my workhorse. And then I have this one as a backup, which is a 24-72.8 Sigma. And this, I love this lens. I've had it for years too. And now I can carry them both in there with two camera bodies, so I have two full bodies and all of my gear, which is what I was going for. Anyway, we're going to end this off one more time for the final time this time, guys. So anyway, with this setup, you're looking at right around $300. Do I think it's worth it? I don't know yet. That's remained to be seen. This thing I paid $35 for, and it's been all over the world. It's been to Paris 4 times, London, Switzerland, Germany, Spain, Rome. So yeah, it's been an amazing, amazing bag. It's even got a cell phone holder on it, you know what I mean? So you really can't beat this backpack. And with all of the dividers, I mean, I keep my exposure, you know, doing my white balance card, there's my gray cards. So all of this stuff, look, there's my cyber sinks for my strobes. Look at that, we've got, we've got everything in this bag. Shutter release cords, you name it. So all of this is gonna have to transfer over. I'm not sure how that's gonna work, but I'm kind of out of room already. But everything that I've got in this bag, I can carry in this one, but the two lenses with the two grips. Even this one, I can carry my laptop in. So anyway, again, I'm rambling. We're gonna get out of here. But this has been a unboxing of the Pelican 1510 SOC. Is that what I said? Yes, no, SC. Pelican 1510 SC. Just the Pelican alone is a 1510. With all of this stuff in it, makes it a 1510 SC. Have a great day, guys. Bye-bye.